So, you want to make your very own spooky alternate reality game, or ARG. Well, you should know that thousands of these things exist, but I'm sure you could care less. First things first, you need a spooky name. This usually could be something with a short noun attached to it. For simplicity's sake, we'll go to a random word generator and have that be the title of our game. The Initiative. This should do. Okay, so the next thing you're going to want to do is make a YouTube channel for your ARG, as well as a Twitter account. Once you're done doing all that fun stuff, be sure to create some really low-effort graphics for yourself in either GIMP or your totally not pirated copy of Photoshop. Either one will do. For professionalism's sake, I'll be using Photoshop. For your banner, simply create somewhat of a noise texture and use a font that could be somewhat reminiscent of a VHS tape because, well, that's kind of spooky and kind of reminds me of old stuff. As for your logo, you're going to want to pick something kind of symbolic. Since the Initiative is always watching, because that's also super spooky, we'll put a silhouette of an owl as our logo on top of some noise. Now that we have the basics set up, we can move on to tactics we can use in order to grow our content. But of course, before we do that, we need a bit of content. For this, I suggest going for a walk with a cheap camera or your phone and recording scenery. Trees, the sky, and the sidewalk you're walking on should all do just fine. Also, make sure to get a couple clips of you running for no apparent reason, because this tends to add intensity and fiercity to your content, for whatever reason. Be sure to include reversed music, because that's also really scary. Once you're done going for a walk, be sure to throw your footage into Sony Vegas, where you'll throw a metric fuck ton of filters on your content to make it look extra spooky. Like, you just registered a 19 out of a possible 10 on the spookiness scale. But what could make your content go the extra mile? What could give you that one other point to make it a 20 out of 10? Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce you to the wonderful world of encoding. You see, with encoding, you can make your videos even more spooky. I find that the website unit-conversion.info offers a wide variety of different codes for you to encrypt messages with, including the most popular one, hexadecimal. Binary and ASCII also work pretty well. But, Dark Archive, what messages could I possibly be encrypting into my videos? Well, that's simple. It can literally be anything you want. What you really want to do is give the illusion of an overarching narrative without actually having one. For instance, for the video we're making, we'll place a bunch of random and unnecessary encoded messages that offer vague statements like, must hide, survival is necessary, and of course, have to escape. You don't have to provide context as to who or what it is that you must escape and hide from, or who they are. After all, it should be assumed that the Initiative is the antagonist here, correct? But then wait, why is someone who's running away from the Initiative controlling the Initiative's YouTube channel? That's enough questions. Now on to the next portion. How to get your newest video some good old-fashioned views. Well, the first thing you're going to want to do is follow every single online investigator on Twitter. The big ones, like Scare Theater, Nexpo, Rainbot, Trosty Guide, Nightmind, and Inside of Mind. I don't know whose mind, but it's inside one, and that's all that matters. You can also follow that Dark Archive guy if you want. Not that you'd have to or anything, but he seems like a cool guy. Third person narration as a shameless self-promotion tactic aside, after following all of them, make very vague tweets in their general direction and maybe even go as far as to find their emails and send them very vague or encrypted messages. After a while, you may end up pissing them off. This is because nobody likes a self-promoter, but then again, how are you supposed to gain a decent following, right? Couldn't exactly have to do with being more creative or anything like that. Perhaps if you're lucky enough, you'll be posted about on Reddit. That is, if you didn't make an alt account yourself and post about yourself already. Now, all that's left is to sit back and wait for your poor ARG to lift up off the ground. Oh, and before I go, do know that if you get any sort of harsh criticism sent in your general direction, to please stress that you're just artistically expressing yourself. Also, be sure to vilify everyone who criticizes you, thus creating a more toxic atmosphere surrounding ARGs and the YouTube horror community as a whole. Thank you, and happy... gaming. I guess.